time now is 7:24. In a surprise move last week, the Federal Reserve cut its interest rates by a whopping 0.5% in an effort to boost the economy. So how does this impact you? Joining us now to help answer those questions is Certified Financial Planner Joe Bert. Joe, good morning.
Good morning, Andrea. See you.
So why did the Federal Reserve do this now?
Well, they were a little nervous about the coronavirus impact and its effect on the economy, the supply chain breaking down, and they thought it'd be a stimulus, but the day after they did it, the market plunged, and then it came back, and then it plunged again. So it wasn't that effective.
The roller coaster ride on the market continues. You talked about the fair.
We had a... Central Florida Fair, we had a fair on the roller coaster last week.
The Ferris wheel going up and down and around. What type of borrowing is most affected and impacted by this recent cut?
Well, a half a point rate cut is affecting mortgage rates. The 10-year Treasury, which is what mortgage rates are tied to, is now at 0.7%. Would you lend your money to anybody for 0.7% for 10 years?
Wow.
So it's coming down. Interest rates, 30-year mortgage today, about 3.25%. 15-year, 2.75%.
So this is at an all-time low.
It is. Correct? Yeah. Yes. This is the time to borrow money. If you're looking for housing, this is the time to do it.
Will we get an opportunity to borrow more at these rates, or is that still kind of in a particular window?
Well, when interest rates go up, of course, the rates will change. I think they're going to stay this way for a while, but this is a great opportunity.
Okay, let's talk about this. Is it a good time to refinance?
Great time, simply because the words I said, excuse me, if you got an interest rate above, let's say, 4.75%, this is a good time to be looking at refinancing your interest rate. If you plan on staying in your house for at least 5 years, because you get closing costs and surveys and all that stuff goes along with it.
That's the important caveat. You've got to be staying there a little bit longer.
Yes, okay. Exactly. You don't want to, refinance and then sell your house next year.
Got it. Let's talk about credit cards. Why are we not seeing that reflection in credit cards so much?
Well, the big reason is because the credit card companies got you. There's really no incentive. You're not shopping necessarily for a credit card. So you got that credit card, you got that interest rate. Plus, they have all those freebies they give you, the miles and the goodies and you get so many points off that you're
The extras.
Yeah. So it's expensive to run credit cards, and they have no real incentive to cut credit card rates a bunch.
Let's talk about additional cuts. Can we expect it to go any lower? Any more additional cuts in the works to kind of steady the market?
They say that the Fed's probably going to cut interest rates another quarter of half a point again this year. It was half a point was already in the cards until we got the coronavirus. And then the Fed stepped up last week, and it was unusual because it was between meetings. Normally they don't do that, but they stepped up with a half a point, kind of caught the market off guard. And what that did, I think that sent a negative signal right away. People were concerned that maybe things are worse than what they are. So I think it was a little bit overkill. And then the central banks the following day came in, lowered interest rates, and the market took off again, and then went back down again.
A lot of people will say the markets were due for an overcorrection. Are we just seeing this early on, and will this interest rate cut sort of help sort of temper it a little bit?
Well, the markets have been really relatively smooth for the last 10 years. We got spoiled. But now we're having 1,000-point swings, which I think is going to be the norm. But it's not the end of the world. I want to reassure our viewers that this is not a repeat of 2008, 2009. The economy is solid. We've got to get through this coronavirus. Got to get through the supply chain issues. But I think when that happens, the market's going to spring back like a rubber band.
And even the drop that we're seeing is relatively low compared to the 2008, 2009 thing.
We talk about 1,000-point drops. That's only a couple percent. It's no big deal. But, you hear 1,000 points, you think the world's coming to an end. It's not.
It's not. Great advice, Joe. Where can people find you?
Just Google me two words, Joe Bert, B-E-R-T.
That's easy.
Thanks, Andrea.
Thank you so much.